In this video, we'll talk about a spatial or geometric way to understand how supervised learning works. Now, in the previous section, I talked about a prototypical machine learning problem, which is taking an image and outputting a label, such as cat or dog. Now, to understand how a machine learning algorithm might learn how to do this, let's think about how images are actually represented. So each image consists of pixels, and each pixel has three colors. And so each image is actually a long list of numbers specifying the colors of each pixel. So when we're provided with our training data set, which would be a list of pictures and labels, the pictures are long lists of numbers, which in the literature are sometimes called vectors. Now these vectors can be thought of as points in a very high dimensional space. For example, if you have 1,000 pixels and each pixel has three colors, that would be a point in 3,000 dimensional space. Now, the machine learning algorithm, in some sense, actually thinks in this high dimensional space. But for us, to simplify things conceptually, we're going to be thinking about these images in a lower dimensional representation. Specifically, you can see how we can think of each of these images as a point in some kind of abstract two-dimensional space just for visualization and conceptualization purposes. Now, in this example of the images, you're provided with a training data set. As I've mentioned, all the images in the training data set are just points in a space. And here, I've also colored the points according to their label, cat or dog. So the red points are the cat images, and the blue points are the dog images. And this is what the training data set looks like geometrically. Now, a supervised learning algorithm does the following. It essentially tries to find a surface that separates points of one class, so the dog points, from points of the other class, cat points. And it does this by adjusting knobs, which are called parameters, so as to best separate, in this case, the red points from the blue points. Okay? And once it's found this surface, what it can do is it can now take an image it has never seen before, which is going to be also another point in this space, and it can say, does it lie on the dog side of the surface or the cat side of the surface? Okay? And given which side it lies on, it makes a prediction about whether this image it has never seen before is a dog or a cat. Now, that's basically the visual way or geometrical way to think about supervised learning. And in the next section, we'll talk about ways to quantify or think about how good the separating surface is, which is called in the literature the generalization process.